Today I'm going to be looking at this little wireless USB charging adapter thing. This is one that my kid had for his phone to go with wireless charging puck that he got for Christmas time. This one from IKEA. And this little charging adapter, after a relatively short period of time, failed. You may be able to see evidence of overheating just there and a little bit on the other side as well. So I'm going to be taking this guy apart and just seeing what's inside and what it was that overheated. I'm sure by now most of you are familiar with this wireless charging thing. Basically, you just set your phone on top of it and it wakes up and charges it. So for phones that don't have that capability built in, i.e. cheaper phones and older phones, you know, the sort of hand-me-down that your kid might have, you can get these little adapters, and they are designed to plug into the USB-C port on the bottom of the phone, and then they always say that you can tuck them up between the phone and the case, and they will charge. So you kind of plug it in down there, and you tuck it up underneath the case, and it just sort of hides out of the way unobtrusively. Unfortunately, by doing that, you basically eliminate the ability for this thing to shed any heat. And according to it, it will be putting out about 800 milliamps for a 1-amp input on the charging puck. So right there, there is a couple hundred milliamps worth of wattage getting wasted inside this thing, or in general inefficiency. So I am guessing that that is what happened. This thing just got too hot, couldn't shed the heat, and away we go. Inside here I'm seeing a little blister. I'm thinking that what's outside the blister is not anything interesting. It's just the packaging. So if I cut through there with my surgical little stainless steel scalpel, maybe we can depouchify that thing. I don't know. And it already doesn't work, so I'm not too concerned, but I would like to see what's going on inside. Well, there we go. Okay, that's not so bad. Can I get that all the way off there? Ooh, scorch marks. Interesting. Those scorch marks look like they were from what got hot in there. This little cluster of components, this guy, and this guy, which is an active component. Let me just finish peeling the stickery coverings off, and we'll get down inside there a little bit more carefully. Aha! Little metallized sticker. So that means that it only works with this side, the side with a little circle on it, facing your charging puck, not the other side. That sort of reflects and shields it from that side. Okay, so then we have the circuit board, a coil of wire, which is acting like a receiving antenna, or like the secondary of a transformer. You could also look at it that way, because what will be happening is this guy will be taking the incoming DC, chopping it up into fairly high frequency AC, and then putting it onto its own coil antenna there, which will be transmitting it, or, you know, transformering it, I suppose, going from an electrical field to a magnetic field into here. It's picked up as a magnetic field, turned back into electrical, and then that AC signal will appear here. So let's just put this thing under the microscope, quite literally, and see what we can see. So the voltage comes in off the coil there and there. Got some capacitors over here, a whole bunch of them in parallel. And this side goes through these two devices, which, if my Googling is correct, and I'm not sure it is, because these surface mount transistor, surface mount devices have weird numbers that are a little bit hard to look up. But if my Googling is correct, these are Schottky diodes. Then we go over here to this transistor, and then this thing buggers off down to the bottom side and pops up and down through a bunch of vias and gets really hard to see. Anyway, these four transistors over here are all marked the same. They're called 22ES, and as I said, surface mount stuff is a real pain in the ass to find, and I could not find those references anywhere. Everything kept sending me to 2 and 2222, but those don't have that same marking, so I'm not sure what those guys are. Yes, this is getting frustrating. This one may be interesting. It's marked 431, and my Googling kept pointing me towards the same thing.
Don't know if this is actually what it is, but this is, everything kept pointing back to the same thing, and the shape matches. It is a voltage reference, which I guess would make a certain amount of sense in this application. So this SOT23 pinout seems to make sense in context, as far as I can tell, anyway.
This guy down here is called a THX006. All my Googling leads, well, mostly to the movie sound system, which is not obviously what that is, or towards some different part numbers and different pinouts and stuff, but it's clearly going to be doing some power management, because that's what this whole thing does. Let's get a little closer to the stuff that was getting hot over in the corner here. This inductor no longer has continuity through it, if in fact it is an inductor. But regardless, just given the general arrangement of this, this is probably either a voltage converter, which makes sense in here, or a charge control, because it does connect out to the USB output, which is over here. And this pin is labeled C. And these two are plus and minus, as you can see on the other side of the circuit board. So I'm thinking that C is a control, which looks like it comes off over in this general direction. It looks like there's another footprint for another 6-pin chip and a couple of capacitors there, which aren't populated, so I'm not quite sure what that would be doing. Maybe doubling up on this guy for extra capacity? Could that be a capacitor and not an inductor, maybe? I don't know. It's so hard to tell. Nothing's really well labeled. All these surface mount components, their labeling is cryptic at best. And what else do I know about this? Well, I know that these two diodes are dead. So that is one part of the failure mode. I don't think there's much more to be learned about this particular one. I'm guessing that there is some proprietary stuff going on in one or both of these chips, probably this one. Beyond that, I don't know what else to say other than that these components are probably under spec for the amount of current that they're supposed to be passing. Let me just connect one of these. This is a new one that I got in a mailbag shortly after that one died. I'm just going to connect it up to here, and it's a bit hard to see, but I think you can spot that the charging LEDs on my little portable USB powered light are in fact on, and so is the charging light from the IKEA thing here. So I'm just going to let that run for a second, and then we'll just see what gets hot on it. It looks like the entire charge circuit board is getting hot, but there is definitely a hot spot over there. 67 degrees, 66, so that's the same area where this one got toasted up in the corner there. That is those two diodes. They're still pretty toasty. These transistors over here on this side, follow the crosshairs. They're not getting hot. This chip down here isn't getting hot. But yeah, that is where those two Schottky diodes, if that's what they are, exist. And then definitely toasty over here. Wow. Oh yeah. Wow. That's crazy hot to the touch. Okay. And this thing draws just shy of an amp when it's charging, in the 700 milliamp range. So that's comparable to a cell phone. So I can see why this thing cooked itself. Hopefully, well, not this one, you know, this one, but hopefully the replacement ones, I bought a couple of different brands and I've got a different one in my kid's phone right now. And so far it hasn't caught fire or exploded or anything. So, well, that was an interesting little teardown. Unfortunately, based on how obscure some of these markings on these components are, I couldn't get too close to figuring them out. I'm going to do some more looking it up afterwards, and if I find anything more about those that makes more sense, I'll throw it in the description, but I'm not holding my breath on it. Even people much more experienced at surface mount than me have a lot of trouble finding these things. Anyway, I found out what I needed to find out. This thing is probably beyond repair. At least that one little proprietary chip is toast. Those two Schottky diodes are toast. And who knows what else is damaged in there. Anyway, thanks for watching. Questions, comments down below as usual. I will talk to you later.